My name is Brian Benitez, and this is my last lecture. The world we live in, it's a crappy place. It's full of so many things that are repulsive, stressing, and angering. There's no one in this world that has a perfect life. No matter how privileged someone's life may seem, they all have their problems. Maybe they aren't as big as others, but nonetheless, they are problems. For that reason, people need a happy place. A place where they can be happy and get away from the world to reset. And it just so happens that my happy place is on the mat.
Let's go, Brian. Let's go, Papa.
As a little kid, my happy place was constantly changing. It went from drawing at my desk to anywhere my little legs could run to, and I loved it. I loved running, but as you all probably know, I grew out of it. It went from being my happy place to something I no longer wanted to do, so I stopped running. I eventually came back to running in 8th grade and gave up on it over the summer, transitioning from 8th grade to 9th. I had stopped running at the end of 3rd grade. And starting then, I did a sport called Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. But I never did it because I wanted to, more so because my parents thought I needed a physical outlet for my anger. And they were right. It helped, and that's where I grew a love for the mat. Sadly, I had to quit the sport in 6th grade due to an injury and the fact that my family was financially unstable. So from that time to 9th grade, I just ran and ran and ran until I finally decided it was time to step back out on the mat again. At first I was a little skeptical about it because it was different than Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. In Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu you can do stuff from your back and it can even be considered a dominant position. And wrestling was all about staying off your back. I also didn't want to join because I didn't want to wear a singlet. But as weird as it may be, I often find myself putting it on at home for the pure fact that I missed the feeling of competing. Eventually I decided that I was going to join the sport regardless what I had to wear. And it's been one of the greatest decisions I've made. It's a beautiful sport that teaches you so much about wrestling and life. Like someone once said, the art of living is often more like that of wrestling than dancing. Life is crappy. It's not fair. It's filled with endless nonsense that no one understands. It's filled with people who feel superior for whatever reason. Be it skin color, social status, grades, popularity, and things like that. And honestly, I hate that about our society. And there's certain things about myself that I hate. But the second I step on the mat, it all disappears. For those 6 minutes, nothing matters. Not grades, not skin color, not popularity or money. Not even my feelings about myself. For those 6 minutes, the only thing that matters is how much blood, sweat, and tears you've put into the sport. The most important defining factor that sets one wrestler apart from another is heart. There's a saying that says, the first period is won by the best technician, the second period is won by the kid in the best shape, and the third period is won by the kid with the biggest heart. I don't know what it is, but I'm always looking forward to step on the mat. I'm always excited to go to practice and be there. I love the feeling of just getting to practice on mornings over break, just walking in there and seeing my brothers, the smell of the bleach on the mat. There's nothing better than that for me. The whole practice is always fun. It can be dreadful, hard, tiring, and painful, but I wouldn't trade that feeling for anything in the world. It's calming. Something about the sweat and the amount of effort put into it during the moment, it's beautiful. The pain, being sore, pushing your limits as your lungs gasp for air and your throat begs for water. It's all therapeutic for me. That's what wrestling is for me, a therapy. It's an outlet to all my anger and emotions. It's where I go to be happy. I don't go home. I don't go to the movies. I don't go to the beach or a park. I go to the wrestling room. I could be the saddest person on earth, the angriest, the most stressed. And the only thing I could do to calm me down or lift my spirits is to be in that room with the people who will always push me to be better. In all honesty, I did horrible this past season. And towards the beginning of the season, I wanted to quit for the simple fact that I had stopped improving, and it frustrated me because of all things, the one thing I enjoyed and loved doing the most, I couldn't do right. But the people I met along the way helped me improve and work through it, and I'm extremely grateful for the people I've met. And I'm happy to be able to call them my brothers. In that room, we do nothing but motivate and push each other to work harder and improve, to overcome whatever it may be that we're going through at the time. on the team, we have guys that specialize in one certain thing that they're really good at. Some are really good at wrestling, while others are really good at lifting. Me, however, I've always enjoyed being in the wrestling room, but as a wrestler, a big part of being good is lifting to get stronger so you could perform better on the mat. And the ones who are always lifting and know how to lift have always helped the younger guys, and the people who don't have that much experience to lift, they go out of their way to help us improve because they want to see us strive and be better. Part of my happy place is the people that I've met along the way. In wrestling, we compete as individuals, but the sport builds camaraderie like no other sport does.